Are you ready to rumble? Crowd goes wild. Crowd cheers. They're going nuts. They can't wait for this championship bout. That's right, people. We are back with another comic pack face-off. Wally World, Marvel Comics packs. We got King and Black Scream and Excalibur. Let's get into it. You place your votes. You pick the winner. It's about to go down. Everybody to your seats. Get your concession stands. All your snacks. All your drinks. This is about to be a fight. All right, everybody. After that unnecessarily ridiculous intro, let's get into our comic packs. In the red corner, we have King and Black Scream weighing in at, I don't know, whatever, 7 comics weighs. And on the other side, we have Excalibur number 1, 7 comics coming in heavy. Heavyweight, let's do it. And we're gonna start with Scream. Let's get to you place your votes. I actually had the Excalibur pack just kind of sitting around with a bunch of the other packs I still haven't opened up yet. And then I was at the store grabbing some other stuff and I saw Scream pack. I was like, you know what? Why the hell not? I'm gonna do it. We're gonna make a true comic pack face off, two of the same type of packs, and we're gonna see which one's better. So yeah, again, they just keep popping up like one at a time. They just pop up like one a week. I don't know what's going on. But again, Scream, which I have several of those now. Oh, this is cool. The Black Panther, I don't know what issue it is. Is it 166 lenticular? Yeah, with Claw there, which is cool. Black Panther and Claw. And then with the Hulk, is it 340 or something? No, I don't remember what number. Yeah, 340. And then last, ooh, look at that. Oh, that's cool. So, All New Wolverine, number 19, new store starts here. It is the variant. Is that Ron Lim? I think so. All right, that's cool. Because I was actually talking about how I want to check out some of X-23's/Wolverine's recent series. So, I think there might have been one, X-23, and then the Wolverine, as well as the All New Wolverine, which that one is. I don't know if there were multiple All New Wolverine titles, and I think there was a Wolverines one as well. So yeah, so that's a couple. So I scored a couple Wolverine books featuring X-23 as Wolverine in some recent packs, so that's cool. So let's get into the Scream. So we got, if you haven't seen this one before, I don't know how many of these I have, and we have House of X number 6. This is the second printing with the purple, which I dig. I like the second printings of the House of X Powers of 10 because of the kind of the black and white grayscale kind of thing with the different colors on them, so that's cool. And then we finish up with Venom number 30. Haven't been in tune at all with all the recent Venom stuff in the last few years, except where it tied into stories that I cared about. So that was the first 3 pack. And now we get into, I don't know where to put these. Let's stash those right there. And now we get into All New Wolverine. See what you got for me, X-23. This is cool. I think the other one I had was in the 20s. Again, I don't know if it was the same volume, but I imagine it was. Let's see what we got. This is just fun. I always talk about that just because they're just fun to do. Fun to open up, see what the hell you got in here. So again, yeah, it's Ron Lim. A couple dings on the cover, nothing too crazy. And then, what is this? Inhumans vs. X-Men number 1. That looks like a, yeah, it is a U cover, I think. So that's cool, I don't have that. It's kind of thick book too. Is it cardstock? Yeah, it is. So it's cardstock with a, what's a cardstock wraparound cover, it looks like. Like a double cover over, no, not really. No, it's not wraparound. But that is interesting. And last book, oh, look at this. True Believers Wolverine number 1, Save the Tiger. That's cool. I don't have that one. So this should be a reprint of, oh yeah, that's nice. Save the Tiger. Where are you at? So Marvel Comics Presents 1, 2, 3? What? Huh. So yeah, that's a nice little pool there. I don't have that one. All right. So that was the first 7 pack, which I pulled a couple cool books out of there that I'm actually interested in. A couple duplicates, the King of Black Scream, obviously, and then the Black Panther, but that is okay. Everything else I do not have. And those are some pretty good blows by this screen pack representing there. Starting in a couple body blows, couple jabs, uppercut. That's not quite an uppercut. But a couple good strikes. And now let's see what Excalibur coming in. We got some X-Men cover book. Let's see what you got. See if we can see if this side can take it back. Take control of the match. Who knows who's going to be the winner. Place your votes, people. Place your bets. Place your votes. Everything. Let's get in here. I'm not even a big boxing guy. So who knows? I was like, wait, let me see how much I can actually say without sounding like an absolute asshole. All right. But again, I still, like, they just keep popping, like, these seven packs just keep popping up, and I figure, what the hell, I'll grab them. But I still have all the, like, most of the new three packs that dropped this month. I have all the ones that I saw, and I just haven't opened them yet, so, I don't know. But Excalibur number one, and Black Cat number one, we're going back. And then this is second printing. Amazing Spider-Man number one is our middle book. It's our meat of the package there. And let's see. I'm start with the Black Cat one. That one's, I wonder if Black Cat, this is from the, not the current Black Cat series, the most recent one, but the one from before, which ended, and then the other one like rebooted like later that year, which is just insane. Absolute insanity. But if you're still picking these up, let me know what you think of these. So I just picked up another DC pack, a DC 4 pack from some, it was actually an older pack because it was sitting there for a while, but I had got it for a specific reason. And then, so here's Black Cat number one, if you haven't seen this yet, again, a couple years old now. And Doctor Strange number two. Ooh, this is nice. That is not a second, oh, it is a second printing. It's a second printing variant, really? But Doctor Strange, I don't know which one, I don't know who that is. Then we got Cable Legacy 151. Okay. Yeah. I don't know. Let me see. Yeah. Black Cat one, even though I already got it, kind of. I didn't know it was in there, but I do have that issue. It's not that cover. I don't think so. But yeah, so far, I don't know. Not so hot. Digging the other one. Digging the screen pack. Like, you're looking pretty good right now. A couple more blows. This Excalibur pack was. Tried to throw a couple, tried to swing a couple times, didn't land. I don't know, let's see what we got. See if this one can all rest here. If this one, unless it gets away from him. But again, Excalibur number one, if you haven't seen this. Still a nice cover, I like the pink on there. Some good coloring all around, but yeah. The pink and especially with the lettering and the sword are leading up into the title there, it's cool. And ooh, what is this? Secret Wars number three variant. So it looks like Simone Bianchi. I think it's Simone Simon. I don't know how to pronounce his first name. But it looks like his. I'm not a fan of his work. And who's on? And last up, we have this Avengers number 53 and Legacy 62 Lenticular. So honestly, I think hands down, the first pack was absolutely a winner compared to this one. The second pack was Excalibur, like nothing really stood out here. Like the Doctor Strange one was cool, but it's the second printing, which is whatever. Made Spider-Man, that's another second printing. Cable, which I don't have that book. I don't have the Secret Wars at all. So that one's, that'd be interesting addition there. The Avengers book I already have, but yeah, definitely. I gotta give it to the screen pack because that True Believers Wolverine I don't have, and I'll definitely take another All New Wolverine from X-23 action. Inhumans vs. X-Men I don't have, and that's number one, so I can jump, check that out, see if it's worth reading. And then again, I do like a lot of the variants and second print or later printings for both of like the House of X and Powers of 10. So I think we gotta crown our winner there, and the crowd cheers, everybody roars, takes to the stage, say, hey, you know what, the other pack, you were good, the same company, but I just, you know, all my hard work, all my training, it paid off, and here we go. So yeah, there's it. So let me know your thoughts in the comments below, which pack you thought stood out, or which pack stood out to you the most, which kind of books, which books put it over the edge for you, and if you're kind of in the middle, you can share that too, like, ooh, maybe it was a a split decision. Is that what they call it? I don't know. But call it a tie. But yeah, so there we go. Cool books. Again, 7 for $10 is great value. And just for the fun of it. And I do prefer these type of mystery things over like the bigger boxes that people talk about, because you don't get stuck with like just store suits of variants that are overinflated in value. But this is just kind of fun, the mystery stuff, and great stuff to pack away for giveaways, readers boxes. I'm probably due for another one of those soon, just for the hell of it, just to get some books out for the community. You can try to check out some new stuff to read. So let me know your thoughts if you're interested in that. And as always, just share your thoughts on the comic packs as a whole. And yeah, see, have some fun and share and kind of connect with that. So, happy reading, happy hunting, happy collecting. This is Geno's Comics. Thanks for watching and peace out.